Right, I'm carrying on the video because the views are stunning. Even though I've passed them before, I just thought I'd video this bit. Wait a minute. Just all across there like that. That's fantastic. There's a lot, well, it's stunning everywhere, you know, but I'm just putting this little bit on the video. And of course I've been all over these places, but I haven't used this camera. I haven't used this camera. You can see the heather on the hill there. Yeah, I'll just do a little bit more videoing because it is so beautiful. It is so beautiful here. And it's me and my sister Jude that mainly share coming up here, I think. I don't really know about everyone else. I know we fell in love with it many, many years ago. And I still like to come here, but it's not so easy for me to get to from Weston. You can't bus it, put it that way. I've done a lot of the Mendips now. I've really explored, but it's a different beauty. It's more barren. There's pockets of absolute beauty on the Mendips, though. I mean, like Eber Gorge and Cheddar, of course. The hill forts. This is a tranquility I find here. I talk about peace and everything when I'm on the Mendips, which is true. But there's like serenity and tranquility I find, and echoes of childhood. This is the place I've explored as a child and fell in love with very, very early in my life. Very early in my life I fell in love with this place. So I want to video it all, but I know I can't because I won't have enough battery and the camera might play up like it did the other day. In the end it didn't charge and I need to keep some for Bagborough Church, which might be a massive feat I'm thinking of doing. Some people should park right near it, which was one of my plans, but I forgot to go on Google to check it out. So I do like walking along here though. I do like walking along here. I've got a feeling that little lady I met has gone down in the valley, which it sounds more sensible, doesn't it? In this midday heat. It's just after midday. Yeah, it was easy coming down. Very easy coming down. Yeah, I don't feel as fit as I did. It's because of these stupid antihistamine pills. You need them to stop you sneezing, itchy eyes and all the rest of it, and wheezing. But they actually make you tired. So it's the beauty that keeps you going. Like I said, I videoed all the way down here last time. And I'm now videoing going up just for a bit more, and then I'll turn off till I get further up. So this is Sheila. I think this is video two already. As I've left the Holford Green to come uphill. Hare Knap, this is called. I think I must be on the upper one. See, what happens when somebody knows a route very, very well, and the names and terms come off their tongue so easily, what they fail to remember is that not everyone has learnt all the terms. A lot of people are still exploring. And so, whereas they've got a picture in their head where they're going, if they're trying to explain to someone else, you've got to make it a lot more basic. Well, we're going up. We've got a bit of shade in a minute. Up through the ferns. Yeah, that's nice in the shade. Oh, that's nice. Right, over and out, everyone, for now. Right then. This is the Great Hare Knap. I don't know exact name, but it's something Knap. I've just climbed up from right down there in the village. Right down, just climbed up. Here's the top of this Hare Knap. I haven't walked over there, because I'd done that before, but there are some great views from over there. So I'm on a bit of a mission today. Beautiful though, isn't it? Look. Yeah, I walked down from a long way, right down in the village of Holford, right down there. I'm still climbing up though, that's deceiving, isn't it? One day I think I've been near that hill, by the way, but I can't remember it, so I'm going to have to do that one day. Go for a walk up that way. I know I've been down in the valley there, but I want to walk through that hill. That's another one of my missions to do that. The little lady with the Jack Russell who's parked near me, I don't know where she's gone. She's probably down in the valley. I reckon she's down in the valley. Hinkley Point right over there. Busy doing work on that, aren't they? There's a bomb found out in the, not far from Hinkley Point in Weston, about 2 days ago. A World War II bomb was found and detonated out there. Purposely detonated. Between Steephome, Hinkley Point and Weston, that triangle. I'll just do a little bit more videoing as we come into different views on the other side of the Knap now. We've done a really big horrible hill. I think the climbs ease up a bit now. We've done this, what I call the big climb. Wherever you go, you'll find a big climb. Like I said, I went out on the top there on that cairn before. All the heather is about is very pretty. This is the peak of the summer now. And they sometimes do burning. I don't know when they burn, but they have to burn apparently to protect the heath, the moors. I've got a nice hat on. Homemade hat from my top. Here I am. I've put this on because the other day I went out on a long walk and I got a bit of a bad headache at night. And I didn't have a hat on and that was a hot day. So I reckon my head got overheated. So, and I normally do carry a hat. I couldn't find my straw hat this morning. So this is Sheila, out in the middle of the beautiful Somerset countryside on the Quantock Hills, Somerset. And beautiful views all around me, apart from Hinkley Point, of course. The smell of the heather is gorgeous. Something we can't trap on the camera. I expect I look a bit wild. I feel wild. Wild and free. And all over, look, the different combes that I emerge from down there. Normally I come out over there somewhere. Can't remember which one it is. It's near Bickernolla Post anyway. But I come out of one of those combes down there usually. I mean, I probably have walked up this way, but I can't remember every single walk I've done. I've definitely walked down it and I'm walking up it now. I'm heading further over to try and get to a position that I was at a month or so ago, on a very, very hot day as well, where I went to Crocombe. And went to Crocombe Church and did all that and had to climb up that massive hill afterwards. That's what knocked me out, really. Today, I'm going past Crocombe, but I'm not going down in the valley, not as far as I know at the moment. I'm heading for West Bagborough. Now, what I've got to be careful of is that I go the right way now. Because, do I go up there? Or do I follow this track? It's all so confusing sometimes. I don't know. I think I'll carry on this track, but it could be that I should go up there. I think it'll all curl round the same. We just stay on here. We just stay on here for now. There's always tracks coming and going. And later the deer will be all over this place. Deer. Oh, just look at the heather, isn't it gorgeous, everyone? This is an area of outstanding beauty, really, really is. It's not a very big area, really. But I don't want it destroyed. The motorways are getting closer and closer to Hinkley Point as it's been developed, and this is right, wow, it's in the back garden of Hinkley Point, isn't it? Do you know what I mean? Oh, this is so gorgeous, isn't it? Oh God, I could dream of being up here. My sister Jude likes it up here, and Owen Stewart, her husband's. I don't know, but I suspect my sister Margaret does, but I don't know if they actually go on walks like this. I don't know if they do. Not everyone's into it. Paul probably does. I suspect Paul comes out on his bike. My girls, now they've got dogs, they go over Greatwood mainly, and they only come here with me. And that ain't very often. Because I'm a lone walker, I'm afraid. I'm not very good. I've just met another someone else, just like me. She always feels a bit awkward on camping sites when there's everyone with their kids. And anyone on their own, man or woman really, is always seen as a bit strange. You know, people can't understand why you don't want to be in a big group of people. You know? It's hard to explain, really. I mean, you're forced onto campsites for security reasons and facilities. You can do wild camping in Scotland, but it's still dangerous to do that. I normally go on the campsites for the facilities. If I'm away a bit, I can use the washing facilities, the Wi-Fi. You've got your own little pitch. And I'm out all day. To be quite honest, I'm not really too bothered. But it's other people. They come up and say, "Oh, are you all on your own? Oh, aren't you brave? A woman on her own." That's just what the little old lady just said to me back there. She said exactly the same thing. And she's got a little van as well. She's a free spirit like me, but she's older. She's 76. And she looked a hardy walker, I tell you. But she did not put a lot of clothing on. My God, she don't want the chicks to get her. Right. This is where it could get confusing here. Right, let me just turn off a minute. Just do a bit more videoing of this bit. Isn't that beautiful? I'm just going to turn off a minute. Somebody come in.